we're gonna, y'all, over two of you, I guess you're gonna team up and give us some information on facilities.
Yes.
The floor is yours.
Okay. Which one is in the blue first? The facilities? Okay. All right.
Y'all look, y'all got the tab where that is, it's further to the back, it's 482.
Yeah, last thing is 482.
Last thing is 482.
This item covers the SPLOST facilities. It's in the same format as in the last couple of years. If you look on page three, it goes under the priority list. The majority, 99% of the architects or engineers have been hired on the process. And then we'll talk about each one as we go on. First one is the Naylor Boat. We bid this project twice. In both instances, the bids came in way over budget. So what staff instructed to do was start working with some local contractors just to work on the only portion of the project. We've done that. We've got some prices in. And then the rest of the project will be done with county forces. Clearing, grading, the riprap. Another big cost of the project was the riprap that we found out in the bidding process. We're working with some local haulers to get the price to get the riprap here. It's got to come up north for that side of rock for the river and the bank. But that's our plan, and the county forces is currently finishing up a project now. They like about 3 or 4 weeks on, and we have another small project that's going to take about 2 weeks. And then we're going to go in with our crew and start clearing and grading.
So we're looking at possibly being available on some.
We're going to go ahead and start with grading. The river, of course, is up right now, but we expect it to get down soon. It will not take long once we get the grading done. It does not take long to do the form report. Matter of days getting that initial push in slide into the river, then we can work up here. But yes, what that's our goal is, you know, late spring, summer is the way. Page five, Freedom Park, basketball court, that project is complete. Good things. Sparkle out here from Parks and Rec. It's a huge daily. Turned out to be a nice project.
Basketball court?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I saw it yesterday. I was out there with a tree planting at Freedom Park, and it looks very, very good.
It does. Parks and Rec, along the long, we've added stuff to it that we had to take out of the budget the night before. A bench. People sit down, trash can, and such as that. The Civic Center, renovation is complete. That turned out to be a nice job as well. They got a good upgrade for that facility. I don't know if everybody's been in.
Has anybody been in?
I haven't been over in the administrative side. I was hoping to do that yesterday at the ham and eggs sale, but they had it over on the corner. And it's filled and didn't have it when we had it. But yeah, the livestock arena and all that,
right.
All of the upgrades, fantastic. And I've had a lot of good positive comments from those of you who bought it.
I know that you've got an out, you know, probably for a few of us we need out there. I guess I'm wondering how much it would take to do some more at this operation.
For what that building is used for, that money went a long ways. And that building got a very nice upgrade. The main thing was the lighting and the insulation. Because we had a HVAC system in the building, but the building was not insulated. That was done in spray insulation. The bottom half was enclosed stadium type building required. You know, you can pick the amount, what you want to do next as far as money. I mean, that, I would say the big part that needs the next renovation would be the, or 4-H's, their current offices.
Chad is. I think Chad is sugarcoating a little bit. His comment to me was, we don't need to renovate anything else out there. We need to tear it down and start over.
That's why I was saying, building C, building B. Building B is the building right behind the building we're renovating. It is the livestock storage. And then right behind that, it is where they do the outside storage. We built that all the way up. We would be throwing money away if we done anything for that. So it was very bad.
Probably going to tear down a new red steel building for that livestock area.
And so it was good for what it was used for then. The air, the ceiling was a load. One bar joist come across with 80 feet probably. And you know, you get people climbing the railings to get from hog pens or steer shivers. And again, the lighting. Recommend adding on to it. The only thing he would add, do is whatever.
still built.
In 1991.
Yeah.
Was it 89?
9 was like 100 and years or something.
It was like trying to make it.
Well, the structural engineer cited to me that it was poor construction.
So the issue we're having to look at, obviously, is in such shape that we cannot add to it. The dilemma we're facing is to continue to use the facility until we can utilize this $800,000 and look to another SPLOST. Because $800,000 is not going to build you a comparable building for the size of what you've got and the needs that you have. Fair to say?
Yes, sir. I do not have that with me there. I do have a number of square footage that, well,
it can't be more than 2,500 or 3,000 square feet.
I think it's around 6, I want to say around 6,000 square feet.
Pretty good size.
That's added in animal shelter.
100.
When we were looking at the proposal for the new SPLOST, this SPLOST bid price was 2,300. At that time, I believe it was 6,000 square feet.
Does that include any specialty type equipment or anything special?
That includes everything. That's right. That includes everything that USDA requires as far as fresh air systems, getting the building wedges to be for the animals,
and the drainage, pins and proper drainage, and all of those sort of things. All that washed down that stuff.
We can't build the CAC for $500,000, that's just residential construction.
And that also includes all new pins, all the tee drains, structures, everything in that price we provide earlier.
I've got some stuff experience with that type of construction in Langer, but also I've got projects that are around now that are 10,000 square feet.
So you know, long term is that we're going to need a new facility. Get it to more, whatever, you know, whatever that's going to be. I think we're going to have to look at the recommendation from the standpoint of, you know, are there patches and stability issues that we can go ahead and do to move forward, take this money here and move it, we talked about, to potentially to the next SPLOST referendum to add to it and put the funds in there to just build a new facility. I believe that's what we're at.
And I can, we have that recommendation, and it came from an architect, just so you just have that information, what we priced out, the exact square footage. I'll give that to you. Library renovations. The library renovations are going on well. This is the property on Lowndes Drive. Property that the library board trustees purchased from the doctor's laboratory company. The demo portion of the comp project is complete. We have done that. It's completed toward the end of last year. Architect has completed the build out plans, and they're currently in the city's review department. And she expects those plans to go out for bid.
Sorry, I didn't mean to drag you into that conversation.
That was another discussion.
Sheriff's Office evidence storage building. We were asked to hold off on this project, and current sheriff is redoing the way he does the claims with evidence storage and possibly not needing it to do it.
Yeah, he was here earlier.
Okay.
And shared that with us.
Okay, good.
Just get right on.
Fire rescue improvements to the drill field and training facilities. The drill field and the classroom plans are 90% complete by Mr. Jim Cohen. We expect those to be complete in the next week or two. We just met last week with the wireless.com, the tower people, because we're moving that everything that's inside the connex under the tower into the new storage facility. And we'll go out and build that. We've completed the renovation to the North Lowndes Fire Station, other than bringing in their new tables and stuff. And we've completed the renovations to the south side. And we'll be starting next on the west side of the building. Expansion. This was just on the agenda for architect procurement. And of course, we hired Studio 8 Design. We've actually already had a layout and some elevations done. The first step meeting this morning. And we expect to get this one out pretty quick. Mr. Ingram is eager to get started. He's actually going to go ahead and get it out. He had a guy that was finished up the project and really good.
Chad, who is Studio 8?
That is, there's eight architects. Jim Ingram, Bruce Smith.
There's a group that spun off of IPG that are with them.
Yes. Are they on Oak Street?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
They just recently moved to their top over Curbo.
Right. But off Curbo.
Court House Renovations. We got to the point where we got the letter done for the architects for the RFPs. Those are going out in the next week or two, as long as I get approved for that letter. As far as my plans there.
Let me comment on that. Y'all noticed if you go through here, most of these, Chad has just rotated through the local architects as far as these projects, and who is, who's been given those. This one, everybody wants. Everybody is clamoring, for whatever reason, to do this, mainly because I think they are pretty sure that $2 million is only the beginning and it's going to be a lot more and so forth. But that's the purpose of doing the RFP on this one, so you guys don't get hammered, or any of us, but especially don't get hammered from architects and why did they let me do it, why did they let me do it. You gave some to this one, why not give me that one? Those kind of things.
Chad, did y'all want to do something with the windows on the Valley Street side or something?
I haven't done that, sir.
They look just real great clean. They don't look like real big ones. Because on the back side, you look to the right now, it's like I see really, really clean, big windows.
No, sir, we did not touch that.
Probably from Christmas Day, clean them out.
That's right. And I cannot touch it until we get through the historic preservation people.
Y'all realize that that first floor is. The majority of it is filled with record storage.
That's right.
And we've got to have a place to put those records, and that has to be, yes. So it's not just a matter of going in there and putting them in a box and taking them out to a storage unit. It's got to really be handled properly. And the clerk is responsible for those clerk court. So that's one that we'll have to consider before we do anything with this facility.
We could relocate the animal shelter and put records in the
Okay.
Backing up a little bit to the evidence building that the Sheriff's Department requested earlier, that we could possibly work through that process to utilize part of that evidence building as a storage facility. That now is, of course, not going to probably come to fruition, so we're going to have to come up with some other viable source that we can use, you know, that we can do for the storage. Now, whether that storage is and Paige would have to tell us, and the clerk of the court would have to give us the guidance on what level of security does that have to have. And there are climate-controlled storage facilities that are already in place that rent space for that facility.
Well, I spoke with several of the clerks in Beth's office just in passing about some of their stuff and then kind of being open to conversation, and they are accessing those records sometimes multiple times a day, sometimes multiple times a week, and they said, you know, we might go a week and we might not have to go over there. But there are things related to the records that people regularly come into Ben's office and ask for that they're having to go and make copies for people.
Are records being added to that?
No, sir.
Mm-hmm.
This is just a little stuff. Where's the new stuff being kept?
In her office.
Here. They have two bottles.
Yeah.
They have two bottles.
So, to give you an example, I would suspect that the evidence that was used on the case for who owned Ocean, I mean, Long Pond over here, was probably found over in that
area. Yeah.
Where they were at.
But new records, are they put on discs?
Some of them can be, but then there are some records that you have to maintain the original. So, that's the requirement, I think, that the chairman's talking about in discussing with Beth what can be copied and what has to be maintained in its original form.
I question that data sometimes with records, sometimes two or three times a day. I mean, a facility would have to be nearby.
And we've used off-site storage before, like what the chairman's talking about, before the judicial complex was built, we all use the same off-site storage. And I had records that were damaged. Stephanie had records that were damaged. The park board had records that were damaged. We tried to get everything out of that environment because of that.
They charge you to house it. They charge you to get it, take it to them, and put it back.
And they charge you to hold the space.
Is there one at the airport?
Yes, the one. Okay, answer my question.
I'm sorry, we're expecting 108% of the court officers to be better than the cap.
Well, you also have people, one of the reasons why I believe a lot of folks are claiming, not only the fact that they think it's going to be a big project in the future, but that could be a signature product for an architectural firm.
That's right.
Yeah, so they want to do that. So I think the RFP is for, you may see some different numbers of what you may see.
So somebody should really do it for free.
That RFP, they'll give your qualifications, your history, the things that you work on, you'll put a fee in there.
And what we'll do is we'll put a committee together of approximately six individuals that goes through the RFPs based on the scoring system. Each item they have to turn into us. Narrow it down. We've done it in the past, they're down to two or three, and then come and give interviews to the commission, and then selection of the place upon it.
It's only so that you can qualify the actual
Most of the architects are going to be qualified. Some have more historic renovation projects than others. We don't know the stability of all of them, but most of them have some type of historic renovation project that I expect all the local architects to be qualified to do the project.
Ted, of course, this brings up another item of discussion along the lines of the courthouse, and we've had these discussions amongst the commission as well. From what you're looking at in your RFP from the architects, is this going to be as much use driven, or do you need to know how that building is going to be utilized, or is this more or less looking at it from a structural standpoint to make sure that that's all secured, the bathroom downstairs, the windows got they have to be addressed?
That's correct.
What
staff is looking at currently is what's there, what do we need to do to bring this building where it needs to be historically, structurally, and on the MEPs, mechanical electrical plumbing. It would be helpful with the use, but that can come at a later point. But what we're going to move forward with is the idea that, okay, we're going to get the architect on board, get the study started. As far as HVAC, electrical, structural, aesthetics, all that. At some point, that is decided that the use will be helpful, but it's not actually right at this second.
Not required. Okay. Anything else y'all need to know about the courthouse?
Soccer complex. The soccer complex is 85 to 90% complete with plans. They are finishing up items on the near of the buildings, finishing up the aesthetics, whatever. The fields are designed, they're complete. We had planned on going out to build this pretty soon. What we ran into is when we were laying this out. As far as the fields, we could not get around the wetlands. So we have to apply for a standalone permit, EPD, and then it's a 6-month process. It's already been started. We hope to have that permit in July. We're going to bid before we get the permit. We're going to try to pull it side of the bids and approval of the contract with anticipation of the acceptance of the permit. So we can get started. We're looking at a 12-month plus contract. We'll let the contractor state what that date is, but well, I think it's going to be at least a year long project. But us in fall 2018.
Yeah, completion fall 2018.
That's right. Is that the feeling? That's correct.
And you got to have what other public involvement you have, public hearing. There's a big back credits.
Do you project this amount being enough to cover?
We have thoroughly been through this and this. With it. Of course, this is the only portion. We have 2.5 million in SPLOST 6 that's going into this as well. We have had numerous meetings with Lowndes, myself, BLPRA, and value engineer ahead of time to get this in. And all the buildings will be built. Three of the fields will have lights. The rest of the fields will have the infrastructure for the lights. That was one of the big main costs for the lights. But there's some things we went ahead of time before we did the bids and things to get this in budget.
The total cost.
Right now we've got it just above 5 million.
Dirt.
Is it corrosion or just dirt?
Yeah, that's dirt.
If you look
like it, with any facility or your house, usually the north side gets the worst, or mildew, or anything, and that collects the dirt.
We've got prices that we'll be looking at in this budget when you.
You got some spare time on tomorrow?
You have a little fresh water.
You have a little fresh water.
It ain't the fall.
It ain't the fall, it's the sudden stop.
We have, I mean, technology, what it is, IP cameras and all that, think about the fast room, this is in our facility, and they're prepared for. Man, are we incorporating any of that in design, or are we considering, you know, using remote IP cameras and stuff to monitor, or is that something we don't really need to be into?
George, the OPRA, has definitely been looking at, of course, the new technology, of course, it's money driven. I believe it is utilizing some of the parks on a temporary basis, but as far as the county getting involved, we have not had any, or have been asked to be involved to install cameras from the OPRA. Like the boat ramp, we'll put in a automated gate that closes at dark. If you're inside the park, you can still get out, but if you're outside, you cannot get in. But as far as any other security or monitoring, I never get
one. So we're going to open the door for possible donations. If people want to donate a bench or a concrete table or something to the effort, you know?
That would go through Parks and Rec. And, they, I don't know if they've talked to you about that, Chad, at this point.
They have, but they have a facilities committee, and I know they, I've been to those meetings, people coming in, came in, and they look at the stuff, the items that somebody wants to donate or whatever, and then as a facilities committee, they say yes or they say no.
And Commissioner, typically through the SPLOST referendum and some of the funding that we provide is in some cases all, sometimes not enough, but a lot of times it's just partial funding for those things. But all of these park facilities, the ownership of those belong to the Valdez Lands Park and Recreation Authority, and it's for them to operate, for them to make the decisions after that. We're just in our position, specifically with the SPLOST referendum, we're able to identify projects that we can help them fund to give them a little bit of relief to make it easier for them to build these projects to benefit the citizens. But once we turn it over to them, it is theirs.
Yeah, I'm just inquiring, say sure, say I want to donate a couple yards of concrete, you know, to help offset costs that we're inquiring.
Anything on dates, times?
I just, I know that, and of course, this really is Parks and Rec, and I know you've been involved in it, but we have talked about the Naylor Boat ramp, you know, for quite a while, and I do understand that, you know, we had the allocated money that was going to be for that to complete, and it was just out the roof, and there's just no way to do it, and it was way too much to ask Parks and Rec to pick up that additional funding. I mean, it was so we bid it out twice, still way over budget, but it just keeps pushing the project further and further behind. Again, I want to commend Mr. Pritchard and Chad for their efforts to work together to try to find out how can we make this happen. Can we take the resources that Lowndes County has in public works, and can we go out there and do part of this work to help reduce that cost of putting this project in? Can we be innovative? And they've done that. But I know that I have personally, I don't anymore, but you know, years and years ago with my children and recreation, we didn't have a lot of places to go, and the only place you really had was the access to the rivers that we had.
That's still the case with a lot of people. They use the rivers and they need that access. And that access is very limited. It used to be that you could go down a lot of these dirt roads east and west and get to the river. Now it's private property. And we know how that is, and you just can't, there's just not that many locations anymore for access. So I feel real strongly about that we need to continue to support this area, this issue, try to move this issue together or forward. But certainly on this particular one, there is no other access in Lowndes County to the Alapaha River other than this access. So it's extremely important. Little River with Wicuche has some other access points. And I hope that as we're able to move forward, and I would even say consider the future of SPLOST is to do some additional things to enhance the current ramps and facilities that we have to improve those. I think that's something we're going to need to consider. I know that it was part of their referendum, but the city of Valdosta, through their SPLOST funding, was responsible for the improvement of the boat ramp on the Little River on Highway 133. You need to go there and visit that if you haven't done that. It is much better, very well, very clean, very accessible. So that's the way our ramp facilities need to look like in Lowndes County. That's just a good example.
And also the DOT just finished the one down on 31. Far the line going in.
Okay.
So that one's been completely redone with that new bridge.
Appreciate it, Chad.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You still got another one for him.